Dave Randall, 10-9 CJT. We're partially into the repeater that time. Did you find the manual? Got part of that. You haven't what, anything yet? Roger that. You just missed a reading of all the silent keys we used to know on the Indiana traffic net. That is ITN's observation of Memorial Day. When I think of Memorial Day, I think more of my grandfather's brother, who was killed punching through the Hindenburg Line in Germany in 1917, I forget which it was. I'd have to look that up again. That was an uncle that my dad knew very briefly. Okay, makes sense. Yeah, my dad was on Saipan in World War II, but he died many, 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 many years later, not the results of mustard gas or gunshot wound or the various other things that they list people dying from during combat. In fact, he got to fly over, now I can't remember whether it was Hiroshima or Nagasaki, the day after the bombing. And he said the stench at 35,000 feet was unbelievable. To quote George Patton, war is hell. I guess I could try to imagine something like he went through, but probably not very successfully. Oh well. I won't keep you, Randall. Let me know if you make any successful contacts. I'd be curious as to how that jury-rigged antenna works. Thanks, Randall. You too. Well, I guess in a way I'm too old to grasp your dilemma there, because I grew up on ham radio spinning the dial, and that's how I operate. I do have a radio that has a waterfall, but right now it's in a grounded metal footlocker, just in case, and I'm still happy to just spin the dial through a band. It doesn't take long, and it's very easy to see what activity there is. At least that's my perspective. So just because you don't have the latest and greatest doesn't mean you can't operate and have a lot of fun. 7-3, and the best for Memorial Day to you and yours, N9CJT. Thank you. watch.